Hi, AT from CNC at Home. We find ourselves in LightBurn, and I would like to talk about the Library tab. This is something that should be on by default. If for some reason it is not being shown, go under the Windows option, come down to where it says Library, and select it, and then it should show up. What is Library, you ask? Well, very simply, it's a place to keep track of cutting parameters. For instance, under cardstock, you'll notice I have a bunch of thicknesses, and I have one called etch. I have brown dark, white paper. This particular one, this brown dark, is for just doing lines, and white paper is for fill. You can tell that by the icon that it uses. By double-clicking on one of these, it brings up what those cutting parameters are. So brown dark is 5,000 millimeters per minute at 30% power, one pass. That's the parameter. For white paper, I have 4,000 millimeters per minute, 60% power, and this particular one is fill. Anytime that you use the material test and have figured out what parameters work well for a particular kind of material and your laser, you'll want to create an item within the library so that you can save that. And the next time you're doing cardstock, or the next time you're burning big red chewing gum, you have the parameters and you know exactly how you want to cut that. To create a library entry, you simply take the layer options and you just choose this option, create new from layer. Let's do a quick example. We'll just create a box and set some cutting parameters for that, something really strange. How about we do 1111 and we want to have 33.33% power. We'll do one pass and just click OK. That information is saved on the layer, and if I want to now create something in my library from that, I can come over here and say create new from layer. If this was something that I was cutting through, I could set a thickness. I can put a material type, and I'm going to call this stuff. And maybe this is a burn through parameter. And so I will set a thickness, and this is for something that's 1.97 millimeters thick. And my description will be cuts through stuff. As soon as I click OK, we should see that appear over here in our library. One thing you want to make sure to do is save your library every time you make changes to it or before you leave LightBurn. If you forget, LightBurn will prompt you to save that so you don't lose any of your parameters. If I double click on cut through stuff, I can see that our parameters are set how we wanted them to. I can change them if I want to or not. I also have options to duplicate a layer. Maybe I want to base something off this cut through stuff, and so I can easily make a copy of that. And maybe the change is going to be, I want to cut through stuff faster. And so I'll come in here and change the cutting parameters to 22222, and we'll make that 66.66 for the speed, so, or for the power. So double the power, double the speed, click OK, and click OK again. Now we have cut through stuff and cut through stuff faster. So the library is really handy to have. It is something that is personal to how you do your work. Depending on the laser that you have and the material that you burn, these parameters should be very custom to you and how you do your cutting and engraving. You're not going to just go out online and download parameters that are going to work for you. You need to go through and do your own testing. Use the material test option to figure out what your parameters are. Whether it's just cutting through material like we show here, or potentially filling material. If we just change this to fill real quick, one pass, We look at our preview again. Now we're filling all of these. This is a great way, and I'll put a link up in the upper corner somewhere to a video that I did on how to use the material program. Once you've figured out what works best for your material, that's where this comes in. Save those parameters so next time that you want to cut gum, or the next time you have stuff that you want to cut through, you can just pull that up. One of the cool things about this is if you have multiple lasers, the library is associated to your laser. So if I click over to my atom stack, go under the library options, you'll notice it's a different list of material. I have acrylic and cork and dog tag as an example. If we switch back to the LC50 and look at the library, it's completely different. There's no dog tag option or anything like that. So these are parameters that I have set up specifically for each laser that I have. So that's a really cool thing. So you don't have to put in the description, oh, this is for this laser, that's for that laser. You can associate it right to a specific laser. If you have something that you really don't need, such as my stuff parameters, I can just come in here and delete those. Once I've deleted them, they're not in my library anymore, and I'm done. So it's important to use the library if you continually use the same materials over and over, or maybe for something odd like gum that you don't do very often, but the next time you do it, you've got those parameters. Hopefully you enjoyed this little video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Think about subscribing to the channel. That really helps us out as well. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.